Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, President Biden, for this initiative. This is indeed a very timely initiative, providing an opportunity to engage and revisit our democratic principles and the foundations of our free and peaceful societies. Together with our EU partners, Malta continued to play its part in the advancement of human rights worldwide. We have not shied away from our responsibilities. Empowering citizens and ensuring that they have a voice in addressing and resolving issues that concern them and impact their lives contributed greatly to Malta's success in this field. In the last few months, government launched a national strategy on disability, a national strategy on autism, and a national action plan against racism and xenophobia. We even introduced a mechanism that ensures better gender representation in Parliament and made big strides to achieve equality for the LGBTIQ community in Malta. But this is not all. We have other ambitious plans to continue our excellent track record in striving for a more just and equitable society, including by reinforcing and investing in our judicial, investigative, and law enforcement institutions, and digitalizing the law courts. The EU's Recovery and Resilience Fund will be a cornerstone to our plans, as circa 10 million euro from our Recovery and Resilience Plan will be used for our digital transition. This supporting platform, together with assistance from other international partners, such as the UK, will allow for more services to be readily available to our citizens, thus complementing our national goals and EU-wide objectives. Moreover, the implementation of a new national anti-fraud and corruption strategy and action plan will enhance our efforts against corruption, and a project launched to improve integrity standards among all those who hold public office will further improve public trust in the policy-making process. As regards to media freedom, we recognize the critical role that the press plays in a fully functioning democratic society. To this end, we intend to table an anti-slap bill aimed at protecting journalists and media even further and amend legislation on penalties regarding threats to journalists. We even aim to establish a committee of experts on media reform and the protection of journalists. And we have introduced standard operating procedures on how the police force is to deal with threats to journalists. Excellencies, Malta is looking onwards and upwards to a brighter future after experiencing bumps in our road in recent years. But now it is time for me, together with my government, to deliver a fairer Malta. We are in a constant and consistent process of reform and will continue implementing the necessary changes to defend democracy both locally and internationally. I very much welcome the opportunity to work together with global leaders to ensure global democratic renewal is tangibly achieved and look forward to the discussions in Washington in December 2022. Strengthening democracy across the world is indeed a noble ambition, the greatest gift we, as leaders, can give to our citizens, both present and future.